Guys, after I watched the final movie out of the MCU directed by James Gunn, which is Netherin, the Guardian of the Galaxy Volume 3, all guys said, rest in peace to the Guardian of the Galaxy 2014 and all the way to this show. And no further ado, let's get this final review of this team member, shall we? Hello everyone from the Spider-Verse, this is your good old neighbor Nick Hicks, Spider-Verse and Frozen 2 fan 2001, and I really hope you enjoy my The Problem Solvers rant because I have a fun time doing that. It's way better than the actual show. Guys, do not watch the actual show. It makes you disgusting and make you vomit. Hate it. So hey guys, so today I'm doing a movie review, one of my favorite MCU movie ever made. Well, originally I say Spider-Man No Way Home, but this film is 100 times better than Spider-Man No Way Home, and definitely way better than Thor Love the Thunder. Honestly, guys, more I think about Thor Love the Thunder, I kind of do not like that film. That film didn't age well. Yeah, I might rewatch that film maybe tonight, so I want to see how aged that movie is, because the movie came out last year, so I totally forgot that film even exist. Sorry guys, so today I'm doing a movie review of Guardian of the Galaxy Volume 3. Man, that's a mouthful. Alright, it came out of year of 2023, because even this film is a masterpiece, but honestly, my second favorite movie of the year is John Wick Chapter 4. If you haven't seen the first or fourth film, go watch the go watch the first and the second and third John Wick film and go watch, and then you can watch John Wick Chapter 4. But John Wick Chapter 4 is even longer than those John Wick movie these days. So yeah, and my favorite movie of the year, which is another than Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse, will always be my favorite movie of the year. So hey guys, no further ado, let's talk about how good this film is. And honestly guys, I was really going to wait until this film come on Disney Plus, and I was like, oh heck no, I am not doing that. Because not until that Peacock did Disney most stupidest thing I have ever seen by a release date, and I cannot believe they did that, which is better than release the Mario movie on Peacock on August 3rd. When you say August 3rd, that's the day that I go back to school. Like, are you serious, Peacock? I'm not gonna take a day off of school and we watch the most shortest movie of the year. Same thing with the 65 movie. But honestly, guys, the Mario movie is way better than the 65 movie. Yeah, we're gonna ignore that. And honestly, guys, we're gonna push that into the doorstep. So, hey guys, and after I watch this film on HTTACC, and after I watch this film at my friend's house, all I gotta say, but this film is the most emotional and epic conclusion of the Guardian of the Galaxy movie ever made. And this is hands down one of my favorite movies out of the James Gunn movies. And this is hands down one of my favorite MCU movie ever made. And this is hands down one of my second favorite superhero movies I have ever seen in my 22 years of my life in this planet, period. So you guys, this film was a very, very good, outstanding occlusion of this franchise. So you guys, now let's talk about how good this film is. The story was really awesome, was very emotional too. I have never seen this franchise be so emotional than the second film. Well, the second film don't have any emotional moment at all. Well, sure, the second film has some emotional moment, but the second film is just full of a comedy more than the action movie. The same thing with Thor Love the Thunder. Thor Love the Thunder was not even emotional at all. Thor Love the Thunder was trying to be like a comedy more than the action. Honestly, guys, I can handle a Thor Ragnarok, but I cannot handle that tone for Thor Love the Thunder more. Thor Love the Trash, so I might do it. Honestly, I might rewatch that movie and see how aged that movie is. If that movie didn't age well, I might do a rant of that. So, yeah. And so, you guys, now I'm going to agree with some MCU hater that Thor Love the Thunder is completely garbage. All I gotta say is completely garbage. So, you guys, and let's get to character, shall we? Let's get to character of Star-Lord. This is hands down one of my favorite Chris Pratt performances I have ever seen, next to his character from the Mario movies and Jurassic World movies. Oh, I gotta say, he's way better than he was in movie 43. Yeah, screw that movie. And Gamora. Honestly, guys, this is why that Gamora She's my favorite member out of the Guardian of the Galaxy member, because she was very attractive. She was very beautiful, and I do love her, and I do love her outfit, and I do love her hairstyle, by the way. Yes, she changed her hairstyle, and now she's a part of the team who performed by Citrus Alone. Happy late birthday to you, man. And sorry, guys, and the main reason why I want to watch this film is because it's Citrus Alone's birthday, so I just watching this film for the honor, because he was in this film. Sorry, guys, Nebula, even she's not a part of this team, but don't worry, Nebula, you're not going to retire pretty soon. You got talking with Nebula for next year, so stay tuned for that. And Drag Destroyer. Well, the second film was kind of funny, which honestly, guys, I do agree with some people. I do not want to see Drag to be like a comedian. Like, come on, it's called Drag Destroyer, not Drag the Comedy. Like, come on, you're not any movie, you're not Movies of Coffee, and you're definitely not Jim Carrey? No. Let's not compare to them. That's stupid. So, yeah, and Drag, he's a really awesome character. And he's a really awesome conclusion to this performance. And now he's going to the DC, and don't respect him that he's going to be as Bane. No, he's not going to be as Bane. So I really hope Bane will be way better than Bane for Batman Robin. Ugh, I cannot stand it. Blom. Shut up. Sorry, guys, and Mantis. I was pretty going to say Mantis, one of my favorite member out of the Golden, out of the GOTG, which stands for going, as tempo of Guardian of the Galaxy, so yeah. Sorry, guys, and Mantis, she's honestly one of my number 10 favorite female character crush of all time, because my number one is Gwen Stacy, aka Spider-Gwen from Across the Spider-Verse, will always be. Sorry, guys, and honestly, guys, here's some other characters like him and the Space Dog, they're great characters. And Groot, honestly, guys, spoiler word, he say his first word, which is, I love you guys. But when I heard that, it's kind of remind me that Dom Chihuahua for Fast and the Furious say that line. Because honestly, guys, normally Groot say, I ain't Groot, but he say, I love you guys. But it's kind of remind me that Dom Chihuahua and the Iron Giant are mixed together to say that first word. So that's why I cast Dom Chihuahua as Groot in the third film. And no, I'm not. And no, I'm not casting him as Baby Groot, which seeing him as a baby character is completely real, and that's completely a pedophile, actually. And my favorite character out of the Guardian of the Galaxy member, which is none other than Rocket Raccoon, performed by Bryant Cooper. It all got said by Bryant Cooper, you deserve an Oscar nomination for Best Actor. OMG, I have never seen Rocket Raccoon be so grateful, be so emotional with his performance more than the third film and the second film. Because back in the first film and the second film, I meant to said, he was a awesome action raccoon. And you was completely confused that why Rocket Raccoon is doing this. But in the backstory, Rocket Raccoon have watched everything, his friend, his family, all that, because of the villain called High, which honestly, guys, I'll get him in a minute, because he's honestly one of my favorite villain out of the MCU now. Sorry, guys, and honestly, he's my third favorite, because my number second is Scarlet Witch, and honestly, guys, and my number one is Thanos. Nah, let's put High in the number one, and we'll put Scarlet Witch as number two, and I'll put Thanos as number three. Yeah, take that, Thanos, take that as the main reason why, you know what? Let's not talk about that. Anyway, and Rocket Raccoon, honestly, guys, you feel so bad that how he's treating. And so that's why Rocket Raccoon was scratching High's face. And so that's why his face was completely a max. And so that's why that Rocket Raccoon become a Rocket Raccoon. And honestly, guys, and even the animal controller loved this movie. And they really love how they handle animal. Do not play with animal. Do not do something with animal. This is the main reason why I'm so scared of what is going to happen with Kitty Caswell from my Nickelodeon crossover movie for my idea. So hey guys, I'm Rocket Raccoon. He's honestly one of my favorite member out of the Guardian of the Galaxy. Well, originally it was Gamora, but Rocket Raccoon, you deserve an Oscar nomination for Best Actor. I read to hear that Bradley Cooper will finally get his Oscar nomination. The same thing with the actor who performed as Maya Morales from Across the Spider-Verse. Was it Saint Jumoa, I think. So yeah, guys, in the action scene, this is hands down one of my favorite movie out of the action scene of this franchise. And hi, he's a really awesome villain. He is hands down one of my favorite MCU villain I have ever seen. Because yes, you can say everyone about Kane, but at least Kane, he was really awesome villain. But honestly, he's a very weak villain in my opinion. Yeah, I'm very sorry I said that, but he was kind of a weak villain. But I do like him. But I think Kai is a much better black villain more than Kane in my opinion. Yes, I know I do some racist stuff, but don't judge me. I like Kai better than Kane in my opinion. But here's my top 5 favorite villain out of the MCU. My number 5 is Kane, and honestly guys, the number 2 is the villain from Thor Ragnarok, not Ultron. Ultron is a weak villain. And number 3, Thanos. Number 2, Scarlet Witch. And my number one, Hai. So Hai, he's a really awesome villain. He is hands down one of my favorite villains out of the Guardians of the Galaxy. He's way better than the villain from Volume 1, because that Volume 1 villain of this franchise was a very weak villain, and I did not like that villain at all. And I do like the villain for Volume 2, which is Peter Quill's father, but I do like Kai better than the villain from Volume 1 and Volume 2, because Volume 3 is an outstanding masterpiece. And in the climax, this is hands down one of my favorite parts of this film. But honestly guys, my favorite part of this film is has to be every single backstory of Rocket Raccoon. This is hands down one of my second favorite backstory I have ever seen, because my favorite backstory has to be the Gwen Stacy backstory of how Gwen Stacy becomes Spider-Gwen from Across the Spider-Verse. In the ending, it's all about Peter Quill saying goodbye to Gamora, and Drake and Groot and Raccoon is staying at the city, and Mantis went to her family. No, not her original home. Her original home is this short. She's going back to her original, her new home now. And Nebula, she's leaving the city, and she's going back to maybe Gamora, maybe we'll see. And Peter Quill went to his family and see his father as the old man as the first time. And he was all hugging and all. And now that was the final movie out of the James Gunn movie. So overall, guys, Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3. This is hands down one of my favorite MCU movie ever. Because honestly, guys, this film was a huge apology what they done to Ant-Man Quantumania. Even I enjoyed that film, because that film didn't save the MCU. That bombed the box office so even hard, just like The Flash and In the Middle. All I'm saying is, but this film did a fantastic conclusion of how this franchise become. This is the main reason why a lot of people love this franchise, and this is the main reason why people call it one of the keen of the MCU, because the Guardians of the Galaxy is the key. But there was no longer key anymore. I would take that key away, and now you can go back to your family, Guardians of the Galaxy. So yeah, and Rocket Raccoon, I forgot to mention, at the post-credit scene, he made his own team. So that didn't mean Bradley Cooper was going to come back. No, he's not going to come back. Yeah, all the Guardians of the Galaxy cast member, good work for the DC, and good work for Superman Legacy. I am giving Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3 a 10 out of 10. It's an epic, brilliant masterpiece. For one last ride, Guardians of the Galaxy, you deserve a seal of Nick Cage awesomeness. Well, guys, that's the end of the era of the Guardians of the Galaxy. We have such a fun time. Honestly, guys, we have such a fun journey that seeing all the characters perform Chris Pratt, Zoe Azanis, and etc. But it's time for the end, ladies and gentlemen. Sorry, guys, you won't see this team ever again. Say goodbye to Peter Quill, say goodbye to Gamora, say goodbye to Drax, say goodbye to Nebula, say goodbye to Mantis, say goodbye to Groot, and especially say goodbye to Rocket Raccoon, and say goodbye to all the family member out of the Guardian of the Galaxy, and say goodbye to Thanos, because Thanos, he's no longer a MCU villain, and now he is MCU hero character. So I do like Thanos as a good guy, better than the villain. Sorry, guys, that was completely unnecessary. Sorry, guys, and rest in peace to the Guardian of the Galaxy Volume 3. Even I'm gonna miss this, even I enjoy this film, but I'm still gonna miss it, no matter what. And now, excuse me, I'm gonna play some sad music on it, too, for a funeral of the Guardian of the Galaxy. So, yeah. Come on, man, that's a copycat.
Whatever your interest.
Stop it. Stop it right now. Stop it. Sorry, guys, this is just a copycat of Warner Brothers is trying to give me a copyright strike for this video. Well, that's enough then. But let's give the sad song of the Guardian of the Galaxy. Well, say goodbye to this teammate. We do remember back in 9 years ago, we watched the first film, and back in 6 years ago, we watched the second film. And we watched the holiday special last year, but after I saw this film, I'm still gonna miss this team. But don't worry, people, Gamora, Mantis, and Nebula is going to be in Bad Friend Universe, because there is no longer a Guardian of the Galaxy. Farewell, Chris Pratt. Farewell, Zoe Adonis. Farewell to Drax. Farewell to Nebula, Mantis, Groot, and especially, farewell, Bradley Cooper. If you like this video, hit the subscribe button, turn on the notification, and share this video with your whole family. And I know Muddy Puff Fanboy is very sad that this franchise is going away. But Muddy Puff Fanboy, don't get sad. But at least you're gonna get James Gunn, and now James Gunn is going to fix the DC because The Flash didn't do well at the box office. So that's why a general audience went away until 2025. And the music I'm playing right now is from the SML, so I'm not playing some crazy music or else I'm gonna get copyright strike in my opinion. Sorry guys, if you like this video, if you want to see more, please I highly recommend you hit the subscribe button, turn on the notification, and share the video with your whole family. Rest in peace to the Guardian of the Galaxy, all the way to 2014 and all the way to 2023. And I see you next time, and so long, and peace you two. Thank you, James Gunn. Thank you so much. You be a part of this family. I do appreciate that. And now, we are going to miss you of the deep of heart. And this is Snake Hicks 2001 video signing off. And this is Spider Society signing off for now. Say goodbye to one of my favorite member out of the MCU franchise. So, it's the end. It's near. Goodbye. See you guys next time and have a great morning.